And we're back to the studio on Rise and Shine. So we've been in conversation with Lee, who is the head coach of Taekwondo in Sri Lanka. And we were having a chat during the time that we did take a break as well. And Lee came up with a very interesting point. Lee, if you could mention to us on air now about what you just told us about fitness levels deteriorating after 20, 25 years.
Yeah, that's right. Now I'm teaching the army and police. So most of the national players are army and police. But they are starting Taekwondo, their age over 20 years, like 21, 22. So after 4 or 5 years, they can have technical standard. But their physical fitness is going down. That's the main problem. So they have limitation to go more that international competition, that intercontinental competition.
Is it because of the age is catching up?
Yeah, age is going aging, and then physical fitness down there. So now it's very good condition because now school federation, Sri Lanka school federation started just before 4 years. So and then from the school level, they can training Taekwondo, and then about 20, 18 years, they can have technical standard. And then over 20 also, they have physical fitness as well. So we can participate competition like ASEAN Game level and Commonwealth Championship like that. So we can, I think, participate and get medal in the future, that school peoples, yeah.
So starting off from the school level is very much important.
Yeah,
in that
that's
case.
Very important. Yeah.
Exactly. So talking about the other championships, the international and the local national championships that are to be held in the upcoming months and next year probably.
Yeah, actually in October, we have Korea Cup Taekwondo Championship, which is organized by Korean Embassy and Sri Lanka Taekwondo Federation, funding by KOICA and Korean government. So that championship we have is this is the biggest championship in Sri Lanka because all division there is school division and university and open. So school championship will be held on 6 and 7, that is October, and then university championship and 13 and 14 that October, and then last 20 and 21st Open Championship will be held at Escuela Stadium. So 21st is our His Excellency Ambassador Dong Mun Che. He will be invited with the minister, and then so we'll have some Taekwondo demonstration as well. So I am expecting about 500 players to participation. So last year also we got same thing. Every year annually we are doing. So Korean government actually support for every year for organizing Taekwondo competition and then Taekwondo equipment as well. So it has been supporting since 1997 for rural areas, a donation Taekwondo equipment and then for national players, a national team. Yeah. So this year also we are doing that for SAF game, South Asian game, and this Korea Cup Taekwondo Championship. That time we'll have the same function, yeah. So actually,
talking about these games, the national and the international championship games that are coming up. So, how are the preparations done in terms of the national team being prepared for these games?
For in the future games.
Yes.
So national teams are now training Monday, Wednesday, Friday, every day, every Monday, Wednesday, Friday at sports hostel. That newly built one, Colombo 7. So there are all national players are coming and training for this SAF game for next year to get the medal, gold medal. And then before that, we'll participate in some international competition. We are trying to get to participate to have more experience. I think we can get gold medal this time on the SAF game. But we should think not only SAF in the more level, not this.
So Lee, when you take a look now at the school level of players who are actually competing, do you see the potential to go to the international standard?
School level?
Yes.
School level is because they started just 3 years. Yeah, that is a junior team, I call junior championship. But now last year they participated in Malaysia Open Championship and they got 5 bronze medal. The short period of training time, but they got that. But in the future, I think they can get more medal. So that person, if they come over 20 years, we can have more experience and then more training to go international more this high-level international competition, I think.
Lee, personally for you, as a coach, as the head coach of the country, what would be the biggest achievement that you could get in your career?
Here it is in Sri Lanka, Sri Lanka team. Sri Lanka team, I think world military champion, that is the biggest one, I think. World game, that is the world level, this the bronze medal, that is the biggest, and SAP game, that is the medal, that is the biggest world game level, yeah.
So Lee, say now you're taking part in a competition. Say you were to be the person who is a competitor, and then what would be going through your mind? What should be your mindset like before a game?
They should have self-confidence first, but self-confidence is just not coming. They should have the training after that, they can get self-confidence. Just some player, they don't training, just come participate. That's nothing to get. So they should have confidence with their training. And that is the main point, I think. So, and then in Sri Lanka player, they should have they should love their country, I have to do something for Sri Lanka country. Yeah, they should. I think as a national player, they have to do. They should have, then mind. Yeah.
And in fact, talking about the rules and regulations of Taekwondo with the coming up games, and how are these now? Actually, you've been taking part in Taekwondo since you were 7 years or so. So, talking about the rules.
Yeah, actually, rule, because I have been an international referee for more than 10 years now. So I'll tell exactly this in, rule. Now is we have there are many rules, but main point I'll tell. Taekwondo is 4 points. That is. 1 point, 2 point, 3 point, 4 point system. So 1 point is if who attack with a punch to trunk, that's 1 point. And then just the kicking to trunk, also 1 point. And then turning and kick, that is 2 point. And then if they kick to head, that is 3 point. And then turning and head, kicking, that is 4 point. That is the main point system. And then there are some penalty also. If they holding, gloving, punch to head, and then there is a minus point, like we call 경고. And then if we have 2 경고, opponent will get plus 1 point, like that. So there are many this penalty, about 10 penalty. There is crossing the boundary line, intentionally falling down, and then this avoiding the match, undesirable act to player or coach, and then like that is 경고 penalty. Then attacking after Galio, and then what is the falling down player attacking like that. That is 감점 point, serious 감점 point. Like that we have this that some 경고 and 감점 point. Although there are so many, so I think in 30 minutes difficult, but this main point is like that. That point system and 경고 and 감점 penalty. Yes, yes.
All right, so Lee, if you could give us the final question to you. What are your future plans at the moment?
In the future?
Yeah.
For me?
Yes.
For the national player?
And for yourself, what are you going to do in the future?
Myself, I would like to write one book. It's Taekwondo, regarding the Taekwondo, in the as possible English and Sinhala. So if who can see the book, they can get some knowledge regarding Taekwondo. And then in Sri Lanka, but it's actually I want to study more in physical education, but actually in Sri Lanka, no, it's a doctoral level course or some physical education, that's a problem. But anyhow, if I have a chance, I want to study more, yes.
So that is personally, you want to write a book, Lee. Why do you want to write a book in particular?
So actually, I love Taekwondo. And then I have this in my experience, Taekwondo. So I want to give my experience to others. Not only technique, my experience so they can see. And then not only this Sri Lanka, is some Korean people. So who is teaching Taekwondo in developing country? What is difficulty? What they should do? What their plan? Everything. How can develop Taekwondo in developing country, especially? Yeah, so I want to.
So
yeah.
Personal experience is actually key, and I guess that's what you want to pass on to the future generations.
Yeah, I guess.
Thank you very much. It's been
thank
an absolute pleasure
much.
To have you in the studio.
Thank you very much for being here.
All right, we're going to wind up things on Rise and Shine on a Sporty Sunday. We shall be back tomorrow, but not with a Sporty Sunday. It's of course going to be one of those Mondays. Bye bye, everybody. Have yourself a super Sunday at home.
When the sand is